Hello? No, sir, I couldn't find him.
God damn it! Where the hell is he?
It's your father. I asked the conductor. Yes, I had him caged. I'm sorry, sir. Sir? Sir? He's gonna kill me.
Oh, he will not. He doesn't know how to yell at. He's known to kick the way you do.
Maggie, the man is 2 hours late. The rehearsal starts in 10 minutes.
He'll be here, Max. Tito Morelli. He's a genius. He's just so thick like other people.
So you're saying he's a grown man and he can't tell time?
I'm just not worried, okay?
Oh, Max, just think it. Tonight the curtain rises and he walks off there on stage. And suddenly, there's nothing else in the world but that. That voice.
I can sing too, you know.
Oh, Max!
I can't really. Oh, Max!
You don't sing like Tito Morelli.
Not yet, okay.
You don't!
In your opinion, it's a matter of taste.
Oh, it is not. How would you fool yourself? He's a star, Max. He sings all over the world. He's a life magazine.
So is Rin Tin Tin.
Oh, and he's very sensitive.
And how do you know that?
Oh, because I met him last year.
And you did? You never told me that.
Oh, it was no big thing. When I was in Italy with Daddy, he went to Scotland. He was not in. Well, afterwards, we went backstage, and there he was, all by himself behind the curtain. He was wearing this little loincloth. His whole body was pouring. Anyway, he looked up, and he saw us, and you know what he did next. He kissed my paws.
Yes, so what?
It was romantic.
He's Italian. They kiss everything.
Oh, bad, forget.
If it moves, they kiss.
Max.
So what else happened?
Nothing. Oh, that's important.
Something else happened?
Oh, not really.
Something sort of happened?
It wasn't important.
What happened?
It was nothing. I fainted.
You fainted?
With cluster and heat and all the excitement. And everything suddenly my blood is like an onion back here. He was talking to me, sort of stared right at me, and I blacked out.
This is great. I mean, this is terrific. So, my fiance meets this sweaty Italian guy, and she keels over.
From the heat, and I'm not your fiancé now.
But wait a minute. Did I ask you to marry me or what? Hmm? Do you remember that? Or did you black out during your proposal?
I heard it last, and I said no.
You said you'd think about it.
Hey, Max, I'm just not ready yet. I need something special first, something wonderful and romantic.
I'm not romantic. I don't believe this. What do you call a robot at 3 a.m., huh? Moonlight shimmering on the water, nobody for miles.
You lost the oars.
It was fun. It turned out fun.
We spent 30 hours in a rowboat, Max.
That's not the point.
Oh, Max, I haven't had any fling.
Fling?
Fling.
I've been asking you to fling with me for 3 years. I begged you.
Don't mean that.
I just think I need some quiet experience.
Oh, I get you. You mean like Diana.
Diana?
Esperona, soprano.
Oh, her.
She's flinging her way through the whole cast. All the men are getting flung out. You should see the guy playing the piano. He's supposed to be evil. He can hardly walk.
Max!
He's looking now.
Listen, Max, let's be honest. When you kiss me, do you hear anything special?
Like what?
Like bells.
You want to hear bells?
I guess it sounds stupid, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Damn it, sorry.
Yeah.
What the hell are you doing here?
Well, I'm sure I can be here if I want to.
Wrong.
Daddy.
You know what time it is?
It's almost 1.
You know what that means?
He's late.
It means he's late.
You know, I wouldn't worry about it, sir. I mean, I'm sure he'll get here.
Oh, do I seem worried, Max?
No, no.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, I do. Well, in that case, perhaps you could tell us what extrasensory Max's perception has led you to form this startling and erroneous conclusion.
That's Max Fruit.
God damn it.
Call the station. I was just there.
Call the station.
Yes, sir.
Yes, take your pill.
Yes, yes.
You're lying, Barry.
I am perfectly capable of controlling my own nervous system. Where would Louise not be today if he had taken Peter Hall at all?
Open wide.
Margaret?
No.
Oh, my God. He's been in an accident. I can feel it. He's lying in the gutter, stinking drunkenness of cheap Chianti.
Max?
Pick it up.
Hello? I guess it is.
Oh no,
that's terrible! He's dead!
Selfish bastard!
It's Mrs. Leverett, the rehearsal's starting.
Madam Karen,
How very kind of you to call. No, he hasn't quite arrived as yet. Julia, would you please calm down? What? Oh, I see. Well, if I may, I'd like to leave that decision in your capable hands. Right. Goodbye.
Well, it seems that the Opera Guild Coalition Committee has decided to serve shrimp mayonnaise at the intermission. The refrigerator is broken down and the temperature backstage is 100 degrees.
So what do we do?
We'll play it by ear. The shrimp stays pink, the audience gets it. If it turns green, we'll feed it to the stage
hands. Shall I call the station?
No, I changed my mind. I want to keep that line open. And I want you out of here.
Why?
Because I said so.
Yes!
Max and I have some business to discuss.
I don't care what it is.
Out.
I'm going better.
Wrong.
But I want to see you. You said I could. You promised.
Well, I lied, you nitwit, so get out.
Max thinks I should stay. Don't you, Max?
I think he's right.
I see.
Sorry.
See you later, Dad.
Yeah. I've got a thousand Cleveland so-called condescending arriving at the theater in 6 hours in black tie. I got a 30-piece orchestra, 25 chorus, 15 stagehands, and 8 princesses. Backstage, I got approximately 50 pounds of rotting shrimp mayonnaise, which, if consumed, could turn the galley as fond of a bay into a mass murder. What I don't have is a tenor. Time.
1:15. I'm really sorry about this, sir. I wish there was something I could do to help.
It's not your fault, Max. I wish it was. The question now is, what do we do if that irresponsible Italian jackass doesn't arrive?
Well, I have an idea about that, actually.
You do?
Yeah, I mean, sort of.
Well, spit it out, Max.
Well, the thing is, I was just thinking that I can do it.
Do what?
Well, sing it. I tell you, you have sort of step in. You see, I've been to all the rehearsals, I know the part, and I could do it.
I know I could. Otello. A big black devil.
Yes, sir.
Otello, Max. He's huge. He's larger than life. He loves with a passion that rocks the heaven. His jealousy is so terrible that we tremble with irrational fear for our very lives. It's tragic, the fate of tortured greatness, facing the black and gaping abyss of insensible nothingness. It isn't you, Max.
Well, it could be. I have a chance.
Just sit down. Let me show you something. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? I regret to inform you that Mr. Tito Morello, the greatest tenor of our generation, scheduled to make his American debut with the Cleveland Grand Opera Company in honor of our 10th anniversary season, is regrettably indisposed. But, I am pleased to announce that the role of Otello will be sung tonight by a somewhat gifted amateur, making his very first appearance on this, or indeed any other stage, our company's own factotum, gopher, and all-purpose dog body, Max. You see the problem?
I guess so.
The old woman will be trapped to death in a stampede of the eye.
I see your point.
Time.
What point?
Get that.
Hello? What? Could you speak more slowly, please?
If that's Julia, tell her to take the shrimp and stop it.
Sir, it's him. He's in the lobby.
Senor Morelli. Yes. Benvenuto Cleveland. I'll be down immediately. Presto. Okay, Max, this is it. You have your instructions. Keyword, Max.
Glue.
Glue. You will stick to him like glue. You will not let him out of your sight. You will drive him to the rehearsal. You will drive him back. You will give him whatever he wants, except
liquor and women.
At the performance, you will need a spontaneous standing
ovation.
You will then drive him to the reception, keeping his
over
with his hands
to himself.
At this point, he can
drop dead.
Rolling hair. Good.
Thank you.
I'll make the introduction, shall I? Signora Morelli, whom we did not expect, but could not be more pleased to have with us. And Signor Tito Morelli, who needs no introduction. My assistant, Max.
Ciao.
How do you do? John.
Max.
Max. John.
He can call me John.
My husband needs the John. He throws up.
Oh, the John.
Yes, John. John.
Are you all right, Max?
Yeah, fine. They got the most terrific bathroom in the lobby. It's incredible.
I'm sure this one will be just peachy, Max.
No, no, it isn't. Trust me.
John, right this way. I'm awfully sorry.
Forgive him, my husband, eh? He's a stupid.
Yeah, shut up,
man. Shut up, you bastard. He eats like a fat pig. With food on a train, he eats too much. Then we arrive, he wants lunch. Don't eat, I tell him. You get sick. You want to be happy. He eats like a pig. Two plates. Why? Eh? Because he likes boozles. He wants boozles. Now you tell me, is that normal, eh?
Well, I'd say it's unusual.
What's unusual, Max?
Mr. Morelli, apparently, like to have bosoms.
Well, isn't that wonderful?
The waitress, eh? She leans away. Oh, he likes bosoms, he says. Sure. He's not hungry. He wants more bosoms.
Oh.
In the bedroom, thank you.
Yes, sir.
I'm awfully sorry. You would think people would have better manners, wouldn't you?
Okay, it's no big deal. It happens 10 times a day. The phone rings, I pick it up, I get the funny off shaving. I go to the butcher, he skins the chicken, he sings me carne.
Excuse me.
Questo, hey.
Yes? Yes, Julia, he's arrived. A few minutes, I'm going to be even better.
Better?
That's
Don't take pills.
You need your pills.
No! I'm better than any other self to know.
What's the matter? You got a girl in there?
Sure I got a girl. In fact, I got two girls, both naked. Go ahead, bloop.
Not the day. You gonna wake up a new man? You gonna be a soprano? Oh.
No, I'm sorry. I meant to all of us. To the rehearsal.
Me?
Right.
No, I don't think so. You want to be through? I'm not a fool.
You're not?
No.
What's the matter?
I eat too much. I get sick. I'm stupid.
Then you were right. I don't think you understand. You see, I have 100 people waiting at the theater. Stento, presto, left. They're waiting for you.
Hey, I don't think you get it. I'm going to sing it right now. I'm going to throw up on the soprano.
I don't believe this.
Hey, don't worry. Tonight, I'm going to be there. I'm really going to miss the performance.
But you don't know the stage directions, the tempo.
I sing it all away 50 times. It's nothing to do.
What about the costume fittings?
Oh, I bring my own, in a suitcase. So you want to see? In fact, I bring two costumes just in case.
You can't do this.
Oh, I wear my own costume with Vienna's asshole, Covent Garden. You think it's been another little supper?
Listen. Yes? Oh, my God. Just keep looking. I'll be right over. Julia, don't panic.
Trouble?
They lost the music. All of it.
That's not so good.
All right. I want an answer. I want it now. Are you coming or not?
No.
Right. That settles.
Max, sir.
If you need me for anything, you call me immediately.
Yes.
I'll be at the theater.
Right.
Max. You need some sleep. You have to.
Yes, sir.
You stay here, eh?
Well, yeah, if that's okay with you.
You sure, help yourself, eh? Excuse me.
You really are sick, aren't you?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm going to leave. In my village, they get sick. But nobody ever dies of drum, I guess. And believe me, they know.
Well, maybe you should take those pills. I mean, it might help.
Thanks, no. I need sleep, but not a pill. I gotta relax, take a big breath. It's not so easy, eh?
Why not?
Why not? Today is Cleveland, eh? Monday is New York. Russian every place. I need a hotel, sir. I'm gonna have children, they're gonna look like a bellhop.
I see.
Then I get a test. I feel sick. I can't sing a night.
Nothing?
Nothing. Singing, eh? Singing is like a life. You gotta relax, take it easy. You get a test, you finished.
I know what you mean. I sing myself a little.
You?
Yeah, I mean, not like you. I wish I could.
Hey, don't knock yourself that I'm in the mood. To sing, you need that confidence. You need to say, I'm the best, I'm the next, I sing the mood.
I know, it's just every time I get up in front of people to sing, I get tense. I take up, I can't help it.
That's it, eh? That's me now. But my doctor, he says, take the pills. Phenobarbital, they make you sleep. But I'm afraid I don't take the pills.
Phenobarbital?
Hey, I got it. We have a drink. I don't know why.
No. That's all right.
You got two glasses. I got a good
game. No, not for me. I'm sorry.
You're going to join them.
Right. Okay. Here, one glass. Yes.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Well, that's it. I'm sorry, yeah? I can tense. It's no good. It's all my fault, eh?
Yeah.
Yes. Hey, we take a vacation soon, eh? Greece, maybe? Rent a boat. Seven islands. Sleep all day in the sand. Just the two. Like in the old days, eh? Clowns. Be the last. Fuck with the claws, eh?
Tito!
Marietta!
Come on! Lock the door!
Huh? Now? Marietta, stop! It's no joke!
Oh, I picked you up by making you
happy! No, I can't do it! Please, no, Marietta!
Tito! Marietta! You got a girl!
I got a mom!
You got a girl, Gogola!
Marietta!
3 weeks, nothing!
chicken?
She's a crazy! My wife is she's a crazy!
Sure, I'm a crazy! Hey, friend, I'm a crazy! Hey, hello, bell, I'm a crazy! I got an empty bed! I'm a crazy!
But the anesthetic about no.
Fine! You want the pills?
I take the pills.
Take the
pills. I take it, honest. Two pills, eh? No, four pills, eh? Four pills, eh? Are you happy? I take the pills. I got a happy wife. Happy marriage.
The chorus. Ah, I see what you're
something?
What?
I think I'm Italian, dear.
Oh, I'm sorry. Mm.
No, 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 we're taking that, man.
Oh, that's great!
Yes, Max, so you like the pizza deputy, okay?
Right, and Tito. Thanks for the lesson.
Oh, hey, you got it. Promise. You sound real good. That's the milk shop.
Thanks.
We'll talk to him later, okay?
Right, and if you need anything, just holler.
Hey, I'm going to get the nap now, okay? Maria, I'm going to take a nap now, okay? Yes. Yes.
No!
Say hello. I thought it might be preferable to meeting him on stage.
Gee, that's awfully nice of you, but thing is that right now he's sleeping, taking a nap.
Oh, well, I do it. There's no hurry.
Well, what I wanted to do was get him to the theater first, and then he could meet everybody at the same time. You see, I gotta wake him, he's gotta get ready, and he might want a few moments alone, if you know what I mean.
Do you have any idea what he could do for me next? One phone call from Tito Morelli and I'd be at the Met in 2 days.
Yeah.
So you see, Max, it's very important to me that I get to know him, to spend a little time alone with him, if you know what I mean.
Oh, I do. I really do. Except the thing is, right now, it's just to get him there. And then later, you know, have lots of time with him. I mean, he'll be here tomorrow, right?
You are very cute, Max. Has anyone ever told you that before?
Of course. My mother? My Aunt Harry?
Anyone single?
My Uncle Bud.
You're not going to let me see him, are you, Max?
Tomorrow, I promise. I'll arrange to see him lots of time together. Alone, okay? I promise.
Would you give him a message for me?
Sure, anything.
Tell him this.
Okay, I'll tell him. Of course, he might misunderstand.
Goodbye, Max.
Oh, jeez. Tito! Time to get out. Sorry. I ordered some coffee, but if you want anything else, I can call downstairs. Are you hungry, Tito? Tito? I hate to wake you, but it's 6:45. You'll miss the curtain. Tito? Tito? Get up, Tito! By the time you get this, I'll be gone forever. After what has happened, it's just not worth the pain and unhappiness of staying around anymore. The fun is gone, and now so am I. Ciao. Tito, Tito, please. Tito, now what's the matter? Oh, God, Tito. I hope that wasn't too much trouble.
And how's your stupendo? Is he recovered yet?
Recovered?
He said on the telephone he was upset, his wife.
Right.
Frankly, it doesn't surprise me at all. The way those two carried on, I fully expected one of them to pull a knife. Well, is he feeling better? Max, is he feeling better?
Sir, he's dead.
Well, I'm not surprised. Must take a lot out of you having your wife just walk out the door.
Sir.
Of course, it doesn't have to be the best performance in his life. At this point, let's just get him up on the stage.
Sir!
Max!
He's dead. I mean, he's dead. He killed himself.
Who?
Tito!
Morelli?
He's in the bedroom.
Is this a joke, Max?
No.
Jesus Christ!
I know.
What happened?
He got upset about his wife. He took this whole bottle.
Jesus Christ!
He left this note. I mean, he got so excited, he picked up a fork and he said he'd kill himself. But, and then he calmed down and he just wanted to sleep.
The fart is gone?
No, sir. Fun. The fun is gone, and now so am I. Challenge.
Oh, my God!
I'm exaggerating.
They'll crucify me! Don't want your money back!
Italian bastard!
I knew he'd leave with me.
Are you satisfied? Huh? You proud of yourself?
Sir.
You feel better now? Could have jumped out the window after breakfast.
We sang a duet together. I mean, I really liked it.
Well, I guess that just about wraps it up. End of the road. Arrivederci. Ooh, you son to many announcements, of course. Something brief. Nothing elaborate. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Tito Morelli killed himself this afternoon. Thereby depriving many of a great pleasure to which universally acknowledged that he sang like an angel. But apparently he wanted to prove it. In short, our star for the evening has departed this world in a final gesture of selfishness and deceit unrivaled in the history of comic opera.
I think maybe I should make that announcement. I think it's still in the performance. I think we should.
Oh, absolutely. Well, prop them up and play a record. Well, I asked you once how he was injured in the Battle of Cyprus, and they can carry him across the stage on a stretcher.
I mean, the understudy.
Oh, the understudy? Yes, of course! My God, you solved the whole problem! Skip the announcements, we'll put a little note in the program. The role of Otello will be sung tonight by Albert Broccoli. And if there's anyone left in the audience when he takes his bow, they get stoned to death! The ultimate operatic experience! One thundering orgasm of insane violence! Makes now and then look like the very widow!
Sir, I think you ought to calm down.
Right, to the point! We don't want two dead bodies around here! Just think of the smell. Put everybody in the Gale of Bay right up the shrimp.
Why don't you sit down for a second, okay?
Oh,
sir? These things happen, sir. It was unlucky, that's it. I mean, everybody will understand.
Of course they will! And then they'll fire me! They're grateful Christ!
Look like him.
Blackface. Lots of hair.
Hey, we were joking. This is real. reality. It's called life. Do you remember that?
Max, you can do it. I know you can.
One second. I can't speak Italian. I can hardly speak English.
You don't have to speak it. Just sing it.
No, look. Okay, one second. They know.
They would know.
It's me. It's Max.
No, they wouldn't, Max. That's the point. They're expecting him, not you.
Yeah, but
they want to say that they've seen him. It's him they want to see.
Max, it's an opera. Four acts.
You can do it. You admitted it.
I can come into the bathtub.
You can sing every note. They know you can.
If you at the end, I fixed up.
Aha!
Yes?
You're out of your mind.
Yes, Julian.
You're crazy. You're panicking. You're nuts.
Would you be quiet?
You can arrest me. It's called impersonation.
No. No. Tito's feeling much better. He's fine.
No, he isn't. He's dead. He's not fine. Fine is living.
No. No. Now, Julian, just listen to me. No, don't come up. Stay downstairs. Well, he's still a bit upset about his wife. I just think it's best that we meet backstage.
That's best. That is best, because he's dead!
No. Here's Max. Right. Good. We'll see you backstage.
Max is dead!
Oh, Max!
No!
Max,
no!
Max! I'm begging you, Max! I'm on my knees, Max!
No!
Max, look at me! Max! Max. Look at me, Max! You can do it! I know you can do it!
I can't!
Max! There are 1,000 people right now. They're getting dressed. They've got $50 tickets. Max! That's $50,000!
Oh, Max, Max.
It's my whole career, Max. My life. My children. All in your hands, Max. Oh!
Julia,
you promised!
I wonder what's keeping Mr. Morelli? Is he getting dressed?
Apparently.
Perhaps he needs some help with his buttons. You know these opera stars, they're helpless.
Wait a minute. Stop! You take one step in that room, and I'll kill you!
Fair enough, I'll wait out here.
You're not waiting anywhere, you're getting out!
Fine, as soon as I meet him.
You're not meeting him!
That's promised. That's why I brought the coffee. I'm a bellhop, I'm a waiter.
Are you getting out?
I'm getting wrinkled.
Daddy, stop! What's the matter?
We had a slight misunderstanding. Then he went insane.
What the hell are you doing up here?
I came to see Mr. Adams, but you're not.
Well, you're not going to see him, so get out.
Daddy, what's wrong with you? Something happened?
No.
He's been out doing off the street lately, haven't you, Henry?
No.
Yes, you have, Henry. I can tell.
You better get him out of here. I'm warning you.
Yes, it is.
Oh, it is.
Out now!
All right. I will be happy to leave.
There.
As soon as I get one picture.
You're not taking a picture. Give me that camera.
Oh,
give it to me. You're not taking it. Give it to me.
Prepare myself.
Exactly what? I just want to take care of
Mom.
And for another one moment, we have a music, we have a happiness, we have a hope. That's it.
This is for you.
Grazie.
Just
That's too bad, huh?
It is?
For me, eh?
Oh, oh well, I have to go get all things talking after all. You should then go. Wrong! Wait! I want to relax a bit and take off my clothes. Your clothes! Oh, let me change your clothes with something more comfortable. Well, I probably shouldn't be here for that. If you don't think so.
Hey, I'm going to tell you something that's going to shock you.
I doubt that.
It's going to be a big surprise, okay?
Okay.
Tonight, when I'm singing my love song to Desdemona, I'm thinking of you.
Me?
Je ne me doute pas de ce que tu as fait. Pour la guerre, si vite le monde se trouve dans la même salle, qu'est-ce que tu as fait? Now, in the dark night, all the big sounds they fade away. The gods can roar, the whole world can collapse. If, after this immense destruction comes, this immense law.
Me?
Guess it.
Guess who's gonna sing the lead tenor role in the Refuge?
Hmm? Me.
You!
Thanks!
Alright, I gotta get down to that stupid reception. So here's the thing. Get dressed and turn back into Max. And stay in here with the door locked. I'll go downstairs, and I'll make excuses for Tina. And as soon as the reception's over, I'll come back up, and we'll leave together. Alright?
Good.
Go change.
Sir!
Max!
I just wanted to say that I really like him. I don't think he quite understood what a really nice man he was. I mean, before he died.
Max. I loved him like a brother. But it's just too late. There's nothing we can do.
I guess you're right.
But Max, if it's any consolation to you, just remember, it's going to be clear sailing from here on out. Absolutely nothing can go wrong.
I don't.
Oh, well then, perhaps I ought to order a bottle of champagne.
How does that sound?
All right.
May I use your phone?
Oh, sure, please.
Yes, room service, please. Yes. Yes, I'd like to order a bottle of champagne. One moment. Is Mom all right?
Oh, she's a fine, thank you.
Yes, yes, that would be fine. Well, you certainly are a fast operator, aren't you?
I barely know you, and here we are alone. In your hotel room. With a bottle of champagne on the way up.
Oh, I'm just a tricky guy, eh?
Come here.
There?
Well, come here.
Oh.
Tito.
Yes?
Can I ask you a question?
Oh, sure.
Now, I want you to be perfectly honest with me, all right? Do you promise?
Oh, cross of my heart.
Brutal, if necessary.
No.
Oh, yes, please.
Okay.
Tito.
Okay.
Was I good tonight?
Good?
I realize it's difficult to form any lasting opinion after having done it only once, but did you say that I was exciting tonight?
Well, you and I, we spent a summer time together, eh?
Well, we certainly did.
Yes.
Now, just in case of a big moment at the end, would you say that it was something special? Well, I would take it, Tito, believe me. After all, I am a professional.
Oh, professional! A professional! Oh, my God, a professional!
Don't you think so?
Oh, I sure do, it's a graphic.
Well then, how was I? Tito.
I was trying to remember.
I suppose that's your way of trying to tell me that I was no good.
No, 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 you were great, you were fantastic.
You're just saying that.
No, 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 you were unbelievable. It just went by so fast I can't remember.
Oh, Tito, do you mean it?
Oh, sure.
Thank God, I am so relieved.
So, I'm going to ask you this, professional of yours, you take it pretty serious, eh?
Oh, it's all I ever wanted since I was a little girl.
It's terrible.
Of course, you know, my mother was in a profession. Yes, and my father.
Your father?
I suppose you could say it's in my blood.
Whoa, you've got something in your blood.
Does it show?
No, it looks so fine to me.
And you thought I was good tonight?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, really, really good.
Yeah.
Oh, Tito, you don't know what that means to me coming from you.
Thanks.
It's so difficult to tell sometimes with all those people there.
The people?
You really are something, aren't you? You have had so much experience, you don't even notice them anymore.
No, I don't think so.
Well, producers, directors, the ones that really matter. What about your agent?
My agent is a woman.
Oh, that's all right with me.
My agent?
Of course it is. I wouldn't care if you were a kangaroo. You want to see whether she's good or not, right?
I guess.
I had my chance. Tito.
Don't go, eh?
Very well. Just try to be quick about it. I was looking for something a little more comfortable.
Oh, okay. I like it.
Keep warm.
It is. How do you do?
Oh, a lot better now that I'm here. Are you all right?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good.
Yes. So I think I know why you come, eh?
I guess you do.
Yeah, you want my autograph, eh?
Oh, is that the code for the town?
No. Yeah, darling, I need autograph for it.
And what's the word for love in Italian? Amore?
Oh, that's the word you speak a language, eh?
Oh, I don't want to believe anything like this would ever happen.
Yeah, that's so funny, eh? Mm-hmm.
Certainly.
Yeah. So, what would you like me to say, Margie?
Tito.
I get that.
Tito, before we go any further, I want you to know that I have never done anything like this before.
No?
No. Oh, which doesn't mean that I've done it not for a second.
I don't mind, boss.
You don't mind?
No, I do the same thing all the time.
What? In that case, maybe we should just forget all about it.
Oh, no, hey, no. For me, it's a pleasure, a privilege. It's making me feel proud.
You mean that?
Oh, sure. And I'm going to make it a very special just for you, Margie.
Oh, Tito, I want to be special. I want to be everything I've ever dreamed of.
Well, I do my best, okay? Margie, a very special person who's beautiful to look at.
Thank you.
Yes. Okay. There. Now you're going to have my name forever.
Your name? Forever?
Yes, sure, that's pretty good.
Oh, Tito!
Oh, yeah. Oh.
I'm yours. Oh, you're mine. Tito! Oh, my God. Are you expecting anybody?
No. Max?
I've got to talk to you.
Listen, you told me to go change, and then you went downstairs. I went in there, and I tried not to look, but I couldn't help it, so I looked for the bed, and he wasn't there!
He's in the closet!
I told you that!
You did! Oh my God! He's alive!
Do you really think so?
I was just standing here talking with him! He's gone!
But he's alive! That's terrific!
You moron! He can ruin everything!
That's either him or the police.
Oh, great.
Okay. Whatever I say, just play along.
Nice cap, anyone?
Oh, no.
Really? Oh, sir, I know I'm tired of us, and it won't take much of your time, but I simply must tell you how magnificent you were tonight. You were wonderful.
Thanks.
I'll never forget it as long as I live.
You like to do that.
I adored every note.
Which part did you like the best?
Not now!
When you realize that she's innocent, but it was too late. Oh, Desdemona, morto, morto, morto.
It was so beautiful.
Who the hell ordered the champagne?
He did.
I did?
You did?
That's what they told me downstairs.
Oh, yes. Now I remember. The champagne.
Oh, yeah. I forget.
Huh? And guess what? It's on the house. And I arranged it.
Well, wasn't that nice? Well, now you did it, so yeah.
Is there anything else I can do for you, Mr. Morelli?
I don't think so. A text.
Well, if you want anything, just pick up the phone. I'm on all night.
Out now!
I'll see you later. Goodbye.
Okay. Here's the plan. Get changed. And do it this time, will you? I'll get downstairs and I'll try to find Tito. I'll explain everything. And if I have to, I'll pay him off.
Sir!
Max!
Since we're not going to do the recce,
can I still do the car now?
Change!
feet.
They made me think you were fooling around.
No, I don't think we should do that, Julia.
Henry, he could be dangerous.
I don't think so, Julia.
Well, let's see who it is.
You stay out of this.
Hey, he's alive. I want to see him. Lunatic.
Oh, no, no.
Maria, what up with him?
No, let's see you do that.
Was it?
a million, buddy. Really appreciate it. Yeah, sure, take your time. We're going to be taking a few shots, and then we're going to strike the set. Sure, sure.